Hello, this is Adolf. Welcome to the video lecture series on the course of building construction. So we started our unit number 2, that is construction of substructure, and we covered some topics in the unit number 2. So in this video we are going to see the earthwork. The content of this video lecture is: first, we will see the excavation for foundation. Then we will see the timbering and structing for foundation trench. Under the timbering and structing for foundation trench, we have 5 methods to do it. But we are going to see the first 2 methods in this video. That is stay brazing and box sheeting. Let's go to the lecture. Let's start with the earthwork. What is the earthwork, or what is the process of the earthwork? So earthwork is the process that involving excavation of soil. See here, one mechanical machine is excavating the soil. So excavation of soil, and another mechanical machine, that is loading the truck, and the truck is been transporting the soil. So excavation of soil, transportation of soil, and compaction the surface soil of the earth at another location. So this is the process of the earthwork. Then the excavation for foundation, what we have to do? Mostly the foundation are constructed below the ground surface. The foundation are strictly constructed on hard strata or tough surface. Otherwise, your foundation won't stable on it. If it is in loose surface, it won't be stable. So we will have to construct in hard or tough surface. So we have to obtain the hard strata, this soil, for foundation. So we have to excavate it. So if we are taking for a small building, the excavation is carried out by manually by means of some equipments, that is pickaxes, crowbars, spades, chisel, hammers, etc. So in case of a large building and the deep excavation, mechanical earth cutting equipment can be used, like in the figure, JCP or something. They are mechanically earth cutting equipment. This will be used for large buildings. Nowadays this JCP and all be used for a small building also. So in your ground, the soil below the surface is hard, and we are going to excavate less than 1.5 meter, we don't need to give any support to the sides of the trenches because it can withstand by its own weight. But if the surface is, if the soil is loose and we are going to for a deep excavation, then we have to give this support to the sides to prevent it from the falling. There are 2 types of excavation. First one is shallow excavation. This shallow excavation doesn't need any timbering or shuttering work. That means timbering and shuttering work means the giving support to the side of the trenches. That work it doesn't needed. But the second type, deep excavation, needs timbering and shuttering work. This planking and structing can be intermittent or continuous. Here this is the intermittent. We have gaps between them, or we can keep on adding it without any gap, that is continuous. How we can decide, we can use intermittent or continuous means, it depends on the nature of soil and depth of excavation. So if you use intermittent or open planking and structing, the entire sides of the trenches are not covered because here we have a gap. So this side is not covered with it. So we will go for the continuous planking and structing. So this is called the vertical board or poling board. This vertical board or the poling board of sizes 250 by 40 mm length can be placed with gaps of about 50 cm. So this vertical board is used as the planking or the structuring. So it has the 250 by 40 mm dimension and we are placing it in the 50 cm if you are using a intermittent or open planking. Otherwise, we don't need any space gaps. These shall be kept. These vertical boards can also be kept in horizontal direction. If you are using it in the horizontal direction, then it have the dimension of 100 by 100 mm at a minimum spacing of 1.2 meter. In case of soft soil, we will use continuous or close planking as shown in the diagram. If it is in a loose soft soil, we will give continuous or close planking is adopted and the vertical boards are kept touching each other without any gaps. Here, this is the vertical board. It is keep touching each other without any gaps. Okay. Next is, we are going to see about timbering and strutting for foundation trench. So when the depth of the trench is large or when the subsoil is loose, the sides of the trench may fall in. The problem can be solved by adopting a suitable timbering. The timbering of trenches, sometimes it also called as shoring. It consists of providing timber planks or board and struts to give temporary support to the sides of the trenches. See in the diagram, this is the sides of the trenches, this is the trench. So this is the vertical board and this is called strut. So this vertical board and strut will help to give temporary support to the sides of the trench. The timbering of deep trenches can be done with the help of the following methods. First one is stay brazing, box sheeting, vertical sheeting, runner system and sheet piling. So we'll see one by one. First one is stay brazing. This stay brazing method is used for supporting the sides or a bench excavated in a fairly firm soil when the depth of excavation does not exceed about 2 meter. So it have some firm soil, it has some hardness, but it is not the fully hardened soil, but when the depth also does not exist about 2 meter, then we will go for stay bracing. This method consists of placing vertical sheets or poling boards opposite to each other. See, if we have one vertical board here, means in this side also we will have one vertical board. So opposite to each other against the two walls of the trench. Why we are giving this opposite direction means to holding them in position by one or two rows of the strut. So we have to hold the position of the soil in the trench, sorry, sides of the trench, by placing opposite of the vertical boards and with the help of strut. The sheets are usually placed at an interval of 2 to 4 meter, and generally they can extend to the full height of the trench. The height will be mostly it will extend to the full height. The poling board may have the width of about 200 mm and the thickness of 44 to 50 mm. And the strut may have the size of, the strut may have size of 100 by 100 mm for trenches up to 2 meter. For trenches up to 2 meter, and if the trenches is about up to 4 meter depth, then the dimension, the size of the strut will be 200 by 200 mm. 200 by 200 mm. So this is the stay bracing. Next is box sheeting. This method is adopted in loose soils when the depth of the excavation does not exist 4 meter. So if your soil is very loose, we will go for the box sheeting, but the depth should not exceed 4 meter. So this is the diagram of the box sheeting. So in this box sheeting, there are two methods. One is vertical box sheeting and horizontal box sheeting. The vertical box sheeting consists of vertical sheets. See here, this is a vertical sheeting. It consists of vertical sheets placed very near to each other. So very near to each other and keeping them in position by longitudinal rows. So if your sheets are in longitudinal rows, then we will call it as a vertical sheeting. And we will give this strut. We will give this strut. So once we are providing it in a continuous manner in a very close range, we will give a veil, this is called a veil, to keep them in position. That vertical sheeting should be kept in position. That will be done by the veil. And another box sheeting method is horizontal. In vertical, we will keep it in vertically. Here, it will be in horizontal manner we will keep. So, horizontally we will keep without any spacing, and we will provide veils. From the veils, we will give the strut to keep everything in position. So if the height is more, some braces like this, if height is more, we will provide some braces to the, this part is called braces, so provided with the strut to keep them in position without any falling. The rest type of timbering and strutting will be seen in the next video. So in this video, we started with the earthwork and we saw the excavation for foundation and what are the methods used for timbering and strutting. In that, we cover stay bracing and box sheeting. Thank you.